Well, that's been the day. Very, very range-bound and absolutely quiet and flat. We've been hugging and kissing the flat line right now, just about a six-point gain on the Nifty. For what it's worth, you can call this the day's high. Though the graph has a lot of jagged edges, you'd have to say that it's not been a bad day, actually, because remember that this is a day that's coming after 2 days of gains. We had that big, big blitzkrieg rally on Wednesday. And then we had a follow-up yesterday. So despite that and the fact that it's Friday, usually that Friday factor starts playing out. Despite that, at least till now, the market has not shown any sign of weakness. In fact, if anything, there's some gain that's building up on the screen today. And the heartening fact, obviously, is that mid-caps have really, really outperformed. For this week, the mid-cap index is up about 2%. The small-cap index is up 2.5%. So that outperformance is still in place. The problem today has been Reliance. Reliance and some other marquee names, for instance, HDFC Bank. I mean, some of these stocks have been on the downside in terms of acting as pressure points. But then there's bargain hunting happening. And you can see that in the way auto stocks have moved higher. Most of them, actually, trending on the upside today. So it's an interesting session that we've got going for ourselves. Let's see if the bulls can really build on this and go forward. This is Closing Bell. I'm Surbhi Upadhyay, and joining me in just a bit would be Sonia Shenoy. Well, in fact, let's get started and tell you what's lined up on the show today. Benchmark indices have been trading flat, with the Nifty Bank under pressure. Heavyweights Reliance and HDFC have been the key drags for the market. Maruti and IOC are the key movers on the upside. Kotak Mahindra Bank, one of the top losers on the index, after nearly 3% equity changes hands in multiple block deals. We're going to be discussing a lot of these trends with market experts SP Tulsian of sptulsian.com, Devin Choksi of KR Choksi, and Deepan Mehta, director of Elixir Equities.
Okay, and the markets are under pressure. What are the key triggers for the next breakout, and what's the portfolio call? Are small caps looking interesting? We ask our alpha manager for the day, Nimesh Chandan, the head of investments and equities at Canara Robeco Mutual Fund. And as always, our technical experts will take you through the key trading strategies for the last hour of trade. So how should you position yourself in this last hour? We have Ashwini Gujral and Mitesh Thakkar who join us now with some closing strategies. Gentlemen, afternoon to both of you. Ashwini, let me start with you. The market is definitely off the low point of trade. In fact, the mid-caps are trading well in the green now, about 0.5% higher. What's the strategy in the last hour?
Well, today the market will go ballistic in the last hour. Both mid-cap index, Nifty Junior as they call it, and Nifty is looking fairly strong. Bank Nifty is off the lows by about 70 odd points. My sense is that Bank Nifty will also close fairly close to the break even, but definitely all day we did a narrow range. We tried to come off a couple of times, but we failed. So my sense is that once we get past 10, 8, 20, the bigger short covering should happen. So even if you weren't long all day, etc., this is a good time to get long. Yeah. Having said that, Madison Sumi is a buy with a stop of 140, target of 154. Chola Mandalam is a buy with a stop of 1180, target of 1234. And SBI is a buy with a stop of 1265, target of 1282.
Okay, it's an all-buy list for Ashwini, Cholamandalam, and of course the Motherson has been a big, big stock today, up about 6%. It's been looking at some very steady gains all through the session. Let's welcome in Mitesh as well. Good afternoon, Mitesh. How are you reading today's range-bound session? The bias is positive, I guess you'd say that. Would you look at trading the index now in the last hour? And of course, what about stocks?
Good afternoon, Surbhi. I think, there's no need to change the bias. In fact, after a 200-point rally, we've barely had a 30-40-point kind of a decline. And the indicator setup still remains, looking on the upside. So I would look for continuation. I think as long as 10,750, 760 is not being broken, look at 10,860, which is the 200 average, as the next target area. And take trades accordingly. And I think we've advocated buying on declines. Today morning, we got one. Close at about 10,760 zones, and that was the best buying opportunity. Having said that, right now I have two buy calls as well. Balkrishna Industries has moved up slightly, but around 852, 853 would be a good buy. Keep a stop at 840, look for targets of 880. And REC is a buy with a stop at 129.5, look for targets of 140.
Okay, well, for now, there are a couple of stocks that are hitting new highs. Bata is one of them. A fresh record high on Bata this afternoon above the 1300 mark. In fact, Bata has now gained more than 16% in the month of February alone. And just look at that spike in the last 5-10 minutes. SP Tulsian of spdulsian.com joins in. Mr. Tulsian, afternoon. I know you've not been a big fan of some of these stocks which, you know, have stretched valuations. But for someone who's perhaps already sitting with gains on Bata, at new highs, would you recommend you take profits, or would you just stick with this stock?
Sonia, maybe the long-term investors will all remain biased and attached with the stocks when they see it moving higher. But I don't mind booking the profits at the current level. That yes, the commentary of the company seem to be quite good. They are quite confident. And in fact, the kind of growth targets which they've given for the next 4 years, 1 billion top line, is also seen to be very much comforting. And in fact, Q3 numbers were all seen to be quite good. GST benefits are seen in their advantage when the rate were hiked from 500 to 1000 rupees, for the lower GST rates. Because their average ticket realization per pair is anywhere between 540 to 580. So in spite of taking all this into consideration, probably there is no, this share is seen to be moving to its optimum valuation in the short term. And those who have the holding in the stock can, book the profits now and look to re-enter maybe on a fall of about 5%, which is likely to be seen in the next 1 month. Because why we advise this profit booking even to the long-term investors, because now there is not much differentiation between long-term capital gain tax and short-term capital gain tax also, because long-term attracts 10%, short-term attracts 15%. So if you play on this kind of profit booking theory and exit and enter, maybe 4-5%, you can very well save on the tax and play on the tax arbitrage also. So yes, though it's a comforting stock from a long-term point of view, but we won't hesitate in advising profit booking at the current level.
Okay, by the way, the mid-cap market is really where the action is. So we'll just give you some examples here. Pull up what's happening to a Gati, for instance. 7% up move on Gati. These are all intraday moves that are really gathering more momentum as we speak. There's also Balkrishna Industries you could look at. Check out Wellspun India for what it's worth. Again, days high. Lots of buying in the last 15-20 minutes of trade. And the other one would be Adani Enterprises as well. So that's Wellspun, Balkrishna, Gati, Adani Enterprises. Just some examples of really how active the mid-cap market is today. Mr. Tulsian, I wanted to discuss Adani specifically with you. Stock is up about 6% as we speak. Now, on a side note, there was this report earlier in the morning about the possibility of them maybe looking at a stake in the Mumbai airport and doing some sort of a deal with GVK. Now, that's still speculative, but if at all that were to come true, how would you see it as a development, and is there any reason to look at Adani Enterprises now?
See, Surabhi, except for Adani Port, we have not been keeping positive view on any of the stock. Now, coming specifically on this news flows, I agree that there have been rumor on the street that the other two investors, those who have invested in the GVK, they are looking to acquire the stake. But one has to really understand whether GVK group will also be interested or not in increasing their stake, and whether the Adanis acquire the stake of GVK, that is Reddy's also, along with those two overseas investors, or they remain invested with a 21-22% stake of the overseas investors which they intend to buy. So if they just remain confined only, or they just buy 21-22% and remain as a non-strategic investor or as a passive investor, I don't see any meaning. But if they look to acquire the stake of the GVK, that is Reddy Brothers also, and have the stake in the Mumbai airport to the respectable extent of maybe about 50-60% in the airport, this one, then I see a lot of potential, maybe in terms of the real estate monetization and all sort of things. And Adani group per se seem to be having good command over the infrastructure projects, which they've demonstrated in case of many of the coal minings, coal trading, and more especially on the development of the Adani port, which has been, in fact, many of the ports. Why only Adani port? In fact, they have now 6 or 7 ports, across the eastern and western coast. So I won't be very happy with the group or with the Adani Enterprise acquiring just 20-21% stake in GVK airport, Mumbai airport business. If they acquire the Indian promoter also, then that will be seen positive. Otherwise, we are not keeping a positive stance on this news flow. But as such, on Adani Enterprise, we have been keeping our neutral stance, and buying is not advised.
Okay, buying is not advised. Well, for now, the market is very quiet. It's flat. But there are some stocks which are looking pretty good. So let's suppose those questions to Deven Choksi of KR Choksi Securities. He joins in. Deven, hi, afternoon. The stock I wanted to ask you about was Madison Sumi. Mm-hmm. It's up almost 6% right now. And even in the quarter gone by, in the numbers, there were no negative surprises. The debt for the company has gone down. In fact, margins were also better than expected. You think the risk reward is favorable to buy Madison at this price of 145?
Yeah, good afternoon, Sonia. I think in general, when we were looking at, I think, all the automobile ancillary companies, and I think the quarter in which they are currently operating, by and large, I think one good confirmation comes from their side is that I think the volume pickup is continuing from their customer, which means I think keep aside, I think couple of them, I think whom we discussed with, I think they have not been very positive, but I think rest of the companies in auto ancillary space have been confirming that I think the volume pickup has been decent in this month, and probably I think the earlier threat is not found, I think operating at this point of time of not finding the volume was a threat I think earlier in the last quarter, which is not found true actually. So from that point of view, if you look at, I think most of the ancillaries should be performing better and give better results. The breather is, I think, the metal commodity prices for them. So definitely it helps them in maintaining the margin too at this point of time. Not completely sure about Madison Sumi at this point of time, since the stock is not under active coverage. But I believe that I think the things are improving in general for them too. So certainly, I think would like to keep a positive eye on some of the good names in auto ancillary space.
Okay, that's a positive take on Madison Sumi. By the way, that exclusive story is breaking on your screens now. It seems that Suzlon, in its bid to pare down debt, raise some money, is in talks with several investors, including that Danish company Vestas. So we have Nisha here with the details. Nisha, what have you picked up?
Thanks for that, Surbhi. Of course, sources with direct knowledge share with CNBC TV 18 that Suzlon as well as Danish firm Vestas, they both are in hectic negotiations at this point for a transaction. We do gather from sources with direct knowledge that Vestas is interested in buying a controlling stake in Suzlon and then launch an open offer for the shares of Suzlon. So that's the deal structure which is being talked about. I do gather that hectic negotiations are going on and some serious talks going on, but valuations is something that they both have to agree upon. So those deal talks going on is what we gather. And the reason is simple. Right now, over 7,000 odd crore rupees of debt on the books of Suzlon Energy. Remember, just a few days back, there was a huge amount of concern on the pledged shares by the promoter, Tulsi Tanti and family as well. So that needed to be quelled by the promoters in a clarificatory statement. And remember that 7,000 crore rupees of debt also means a finance cost per say quarter of over 335 crore rupees. And the company is in losses. It posted losses of about 40 crore rupees in the last quarter. And look at the market cap. And if we really look at a 1 year chart, the valuations of the company, the market cap of the company has halved, less than halved in 1 year's time. So that is also a big concern. The valuations are eroding on debt concerns as well. A stronger strategic partner from overseas with deep pockets coming in will really create a lot of sanity for this company. Now, remember that Dilip Sanghvi and Associates is a big stakeholder there. So their approval is required. They have to be in the mix as well. And the biggest approval will have to come in from the lenders of Suzlon Energy, who really owes over 7,000 crore rupees.
But, you know, also the other thing is the reason why the stock has come off so much is, you know, as you said, debt reduction is very critical. For 2 years now, the company has been promising to reduce their debt, you know, to about 6,000 odd crores. This was the promise they made in FY18, FY17. They couldn't live up to their promise.
Yes.
Now, let's see if this actually
comes. Now, the pressure is high also because, Sonia, all the lenders are getting extremely active on this front. And to avert an NPA kind of situation for Suzlon Energy, they will have to take some aggressive steps to bring down their debt.
You know,
so, that could be one of the drivers. They have come to talking table with a lot of players in the past as well. But this time, pressure is a little higher. But at the moment, talk's still on. We are not saying that the deal is a sealed deal.
You know, for me, it's just deja vu. I mean, and it's a sign of the times that we live in, really. So many Indian companies and sometimes even bigger conglomerates, same story, looking to cash out, looking for strategic partners, whether it's the SL Group, whether it's Suzlon, whether it's ADAG, it's the same story playing out across the board, and the pressure when your back is against the wall with respect to lenders. Mr. Dulzian, your thoughts, not just on Suzlon, but I mean, I guess this deal or the prospects of this deal is creating a bit of a buzz overall in the space. Even Inox Wind, for instance, is up in double digits today. Now, this is all within the realm of discussions at the moment. But from an investor point of view, on either of these stocks, would you have a view? At one point, I remember you used to like Swelect Energy. I don't know if that's still a story that you're convinced about.
See, Surbhi, each company has to be individually and independently valued. Now, if I come quickly on Suzlon, if you take the debt of 7,000 crore and the present market cap of about 2,800 to 3,000 crore, the enterprise value comes at about 10,000 crore. I don't find, honestly, if you really ask me, I don't find any kind of value and interest in this. I don't know whether the potential acquirer will be able to execute the deal at 5 rupees and will be able to impress upon the lenders to cut the or you go for a waiver of about 50%. Suomoto, I have my doubts because I don't see the EV at more than 3,000-4,000 crore. It reminds me of a couple of years back when I was taking a positive call on the NCLT cases in respect to the steel accounts, where I have been saying that there will be a lot of appetite for acquiring, and we have seen that happening correctly. While in case of other NCLT stocks, if I just refer those first 12 accounts, where the haircut has been as high as anywhere between 40% to 60%. So I don't think that you can generalize or you can just apply a general rule of the change of guard as a trigger for the recovery or seeing the value coming back into the stock. So just going specifically on Suzlon, I don't think that I see any kind of value. I will rather advise that those who have been holding it, I agree that the penny stocks attracts a lot of interest and attention of the retail traders, and they jump to, they love to lap and jump and buy it, but I think it will be a risky venture. Coming specifically on Swelect Energy, in fact, the wind energy space per se is not seen to be doing well. In fact, it is out of focus, but the solar energy is really seen a very happening place. And Swelect Energy is more into the solar space, where they are into the O&M also, and supplying the equipments also. Apart from that, the company is, if I'm not wrong, having cash and cash equivalent of about 250 crore. I'm referring in respect to Swelect Energy. So yes, I see a lot of value in Swelect Energy stock going forward, because they being the service provider, O&M contractor, and all sort of things bouquet offering to the solar space. So I think it is altogether a different ball game. You can't compare Inox Wind with Swelect, and Inox Wind, even if the stake sale is happening in Suzlon Energy, cannot get compared with Inox Wind, where we are also keeping a negative view. So negative to neutral view on both Suzlon Energy as well as Inox Wind.
Oh yes, sir. So, and your advice is perfectly sane. I mean, a lot of retail investors get trapped thinking that stocks can't fall beyond a certain level. If you look at Suzlon's 2-year chart, you'll see 2 years back it was at 20 rupees, and at that time people would say, how much lower can it fall? From 20 to 5, it's really eroded a lot of, it's only eroded wealth of shareholders over the last many years.